Hey guys, check this out. I'm going to be replacing a breaker, and if you guys have a damaged breaker or you need to replace a breaker or install a new breaker with a new circuit, stay with me in this video. I'm going to show you how I installed my new breaker and added a new circuit. And this is something that you definitely can do by yourself. So stay with me in this video, and I'm going to show you guys exactly how you can do this all by yourself. Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of Doing It Yourself. If it's your first time here, welcome, of course. And to all my longtime subscribers, you guys know the drill, welcome back. All right, guys, today I'm working on a little project. If you guys have a breaker panel and you want to install a whole new circuit with a new breaker, or if you have a breaker that keeps tripping or a breaker that's damaged and you want to replace it, this video will show you exactly how to do that. In my case, I'm going to be running an entire new circuit, putting in a new breaker. Since I'm going to be putting in a new circuit, I decided I might as well show you guys how to do it or replace a breaker if you guys have a damaged breaker. The process is going to be the same except for a couple parts. So if you just follow along, you'll be able to replace your breaker or install a new one all by yourself. As usual, I'm going to leave links in the description to everything that I do and timestamps outlining the video. So if you guys are interested in a specific portion, you can jump to that portion of the video. So without further ado, let's get at it. All right, the first thing you want to do if you're going to be working on your main panel is you want to open up your panel and you're going to see a main breaker here. This controls the power to all of these switches here. If you're going to be replacing a breaker inside here, you can switch this off and it will kill all the power going to all these circuits. In my case, I have a sub panel, and as you can see here, this is going outside to my pool panel. So what I'm going to do is go ahead and turn the power off, and that should kill the power to my sub panel. Once you have the power off, you can remove the screws to your panel to expose the wiring inside. If it's your main panel like this, the screws are located here, 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 you can see them. Just remove them and take your panel off. Just be careful. What I would suggest is remove all the screws and leave one, because this is not super heavy, but relatively heavy. So what you want to do is take your time, loosen the last screw, and then you can remove this panel, exposing all the breakers on the inside. All right, so here's what's going to happen. Before we begin, we got to make sure that we have our correct breaker. And if you're running a new circuit, you want to make sure you have the correct size wire. So here's what I want you to do. The first thing you want to do is you want to go to your panel and you want to find one of your breakers. If it's a breaker that you're going to replace, just take a look at the size of the breaker, and on it should be labeled the model number or the type of breaker that you're going to use. If it's a replacement breaker that you want to put in, all you need to know is the model number. Now, with that information, you can either take a picture of it, or if you want to play it safe, you can take the breaker out and then you're just going to take it down to your local hardware store, or if you want to order it off a website, Amazon or whatever, then you can go ahead and pick one up at that time. Now is a good time to go ahead and also get the size wiring that you need. In my case, I'm putting a 20 amp circuit, so I'm going to need 12 gauge wire. So you're going to go ahead, pick up your wire if you need it, or just pick up your breaker, and then you'll be ready to start the project. One of the first things you want to do before you remove your panel, especially if you have a lot of breakers, is put a piece of tape over the breaker that you're going to replace if you are replacing a breaker. In my case, I have a bunch of spares here, so I'm going to put my new circuit right here. So I want to make sure where I'm going to put it. So I have this label mark. So I have this breaker marked here. Next thing you want to do is remove any screws that are holding the cover to your breaker. In my case, I have an outdoor sub panel, so my screws are located here. So I can go ahead and remove the screws. Once I've removed all the screws, I can go ahead and remove the cover for the panel to expose all the breakers on the inside of your panel. One of the things you want to check before you start working inside the panel is to make sure that there's no power. If you have a non-contact voltage tester, you can test it. In my case, I'm going to check the incoming line, which is here. And as you can see, I have 0 volts, so my panel is dead, so I'm free to work on it. So as you can see, this is the breaker that I marked. If you were replacing this breaker, in order to remove it, you want to go ahead and tilt your breaker this way so it goes towards the clip like this. And then you should be able to just remove the breaker like that. As you can see here, in my case, I'm leaving this one here, but if you need to replace one, that's what you would have to do. And to install it, you would just do the opposite and clip it back in like that. Now, different breakers have different fastening methods. In this case here, I'm using a Siemens breaker. And as you can see here, there's a hole located at the bottom right here. What you're going to do is you're going to insert your hot wire into here, but we'll talk about that as we're installing it. If you're running a new circuit, you're going to have to run new wires. As you can see here in my breaker box, the wires are already ran, and in order to do this, all I did was run a fish wire through here, and I was able to pull my cables back with my fish all the way back to my outlet that I'm running. So once you have your new wires in the box here, the next thing you want to do is terminate them. Terminating these wires are pretty easy. You can see in the panel here, I have a bunch of green wires, ground wires connected to the ground bar here. On this side, all my neutrals are connected. You can see all the white cables connected here. So all you need to do is do the same thing with your wires. What I like to do is pre-measure my wires so I don't have excess. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna start with my ground and my neutral. And what you wanna do is you just wanna get a length where you feel comfortable with it. So for example, I'm gonna route my neutral somewhere here to one of these lugs here. So maybe about that much would be good for my neutral. So once you have your neutral set, you can go ahead and strip it. Make sure you use the right gauge. I'm using 12 gauge wire because I'm running a 20 amp circuit. Once you've loosened the lug, you can go ahead and insert your neutral wire in, holding it firmly, and then you can go ahead and tighten the lug onto the wire, making sure that it's inserted all the way in. The next step is to connect your ground. Once you have your ground wire stripped, you can go ahead and loosen again one of the lugs. And then all you need to do is insert your ground wire in through the hole, and then you can go ahead and tighten it down. Once you have your ground tightened, you're good to go. The last step is to route our hot cable, and the way I'm going to do this now is I'm going to try to get enough of it where I can connect it into my breaker, cut it, strip it, and again, all you need to do is insert it into your breaker, and then you can go ahead and tighten the screw down so it clamps down on the wire. Once your wire is installed, and you can pull on it, give it a nice tug to make sure that the wire is inserted tight, the next thing you want to do is go ahead and install your breaker. Once you have the wire inserted in your breaker, you can go ahead and put it in. I want to show you guys, there's a clip here where these prongs fit under. So what you want to do is you want to get your breaker around those prongs, and then your bus bar is going to go into this groove right here. So all you need to do is hook it in, line it up, and just press down on your breaker, and it should lock it into place. Now all you need to do is just neaten up your wires and make sure that they're all tucked away. Once your breakers are installed, you're going to go ahead and remove the tab. In order to break these tabs off, you might need a pair of pliers. In my case, you can do it by hand, just rock it back and forth. You'll be able to break out the tab. And then all you need to do now is just line up your panel, and you should be good to go. Once your panel is on, you can go ahead and replace all your screws. And once you have all the screws in place, you're pretty much done with this. If you're replacing your breaker, you're done. All right, now that I got all my screws back in and my breaker is in, I'm going to leave it in the off position because in my case, I'm going to go run an outlet now and connect the outlet. And connecting the outlet is super easy. All I got to do is strip my wires back, my hot, my ground, and my neutral, connect them to my outlet, tuck them all away in the box. And in this case, I have a weatherproof box, so I'm going to install the weatherproof housing on the box. If you guys don't know how to do that, check out my video. I did a video on just installing a weatherproof box. So if you guys are interested in doing that, you can check that video out. But once I'm done installing the outlet, that's pretty much it. All I really need to do is turn the breaker back on my main panel, turn my breaker on, and then just test the circuit to make sure that it's wired correctly. And if I got power, then I'm good to go. Hey guys, welcome back. That wasn't too bad. Hope you guys were able to hang with me and go through that installation video. As you can see here, I have my new breaker in. The power is back on. My outlet is wired up correctly. I got power going to it. And now I was able to add a circuit with a new breaker. I hope this video was helpful to you guys, and depending on the scenario, if you guys had to replace an old breaker, all you really need to do is kill the power to the panel, pop out the breaker, disconnect the hot wire that's going to the breaker, put the wire back in, tighten it up, pop your breaker back in, and you're good to go. All right, with that said, hope you guys enjoyed my video. Again, thank you guys so much for watching. I always appreciate it. If you haven't seen my other videos, because this video is related to my pool. As you can see here, I have my pool panel here, and that's controlling my outlet. And if you haven't, check out my pool videos. They're around here somewhere. But other than that, another video DIY done, and you guys definitely can do this yourself. It's intimidating to a lot of people, but it's pretty easy. Once you have the power cut off, you're good to go. All right. With that said, hope you guys enjoyed it, and I'll see you guys in the next video.